Dear friends, today I'm going to show you how to make bread kvass, which is a national drink of Russia. Though bread kvass is more popular, but bread kvass is also well known in Russia as well as in Eastern Europe. Kvass is known to aid digestion, rich in probiotics and protect against infectious diseases, which I think more appropriate to take during this crisis. While talking about kvass, I also want to talk about kanji, a fermented drink popular in North India. I find both are quite similar, only kanji involves more spices than kvass, but both uses purple vegetables, either carrots or beet. So today I'm using beets and carrots both. I'm going to use organic beetroot together with some organic carrots. Just wash them with water and now going to cut into small pieces. Will not remove the skin as would like to have the wild yeast from the skin. They will help in doing the fermentation. Take out both sides from the carrot and cut into small equal pieces. Adding some ginger to get nice flavor and also the yeast from ginger skin, which we call ginger bug, will help in fermentation too. Taking these two jars and add equal portion of ginger. Fennel seeds. This will add a very nice aroma. Adding carrots now. And then beets. I'm using filtered water, otherwise the tap water which has chlorine can kill the natural yeast. We'll add 2.5% salt. I'm using sea salt, which means 25 grams salt for 1 liter water. Let the salt dissolve fully before adding. Add the water. Using a chopstick to mix it well. We'll add some more water until it's full, keeping it full so less chances of fungus to grow on top. In traditional kanji, people use earthen pot and cover the mouth with a wet towel, but they used to make it during winter with purple carrots. But now in this hot weather it can be risky as no one will know what's growing inside the pot. You can get mold, you can get fungus. But I'm using an airlock to avoid the risk. I will put a link below if you are wondering where to buy those from. This will ensure the carbon dioxide forms during the fermentation will go out, but oxygen can't go in, since it should be anaerobic. Oxygen is not good for lactofermentation. Since I have some extra beet pieces, I'm going to use one more jar with same ingredients. The airlock system here is a bit different. There is a small hole in middle for CO2 to go out. You can see the beets and carrots are totally submerged in left and right side jar, only middle one having some vegetables floating. After 4 days, you can see the color of the jar is much more darker than the first day. Let's see what happened to the vegetables. Oh no, the first jar itself got the mold. Probably the airlock was not fully tight and the vegetables were floating on top. Now, if you are in fermenting, you know it's not rare. In fact, it's quite common. You can either discard the whole thing if you are not comfortable, but I am going to strain and take the beets and carrots since they were far below from the top of the liquid. At this point, they are excellent in taste. And I am going to stir fry them, so nothing to worry. The heat will kill everything. The other two are absolutely fine. You can see the color of the vegetables are not so fresh, but the color of the liquid is very refreshing. I'm excited because I'm not only going to get a healthy and tasty drink, but yummy vegetables too. These beets and carrots are excellent in taste. You can just eat them raw as salad or cook them in your favorite dishes. At this point, my kavas or kanji is ready. You can drink straight or put in a airtight bottle and keep in refrigerator for slow fermentation for another 5 days and then serve chilled. But I want to give it a complex flavor and add some carbonation and fizziness like soda drink, hence going for second fermentation. I had plenty of options, but I thought to use passion fruit today. If you are not sure how it looks, it's here. Adding around 150 grams. Using little bit lemon juice for a citrus flavor, mix it well. Look at the color. It's my favorite color. I can't take my eyes off from the bottle. It's so gorgeous. Now going to use a proper airtight one, the flip top bottle. I want to get fizz and carbonation faster, hence we'll add in the bottle 20 ml kombucha each. You can add ginger beer or water kefir if you don't have kombucha, or else just keep it as it is. Okay, so it's around 20 hours and I suddenly heard a loud pop sound, and this has happened. Had hard time to find the cork from where it flew away. Look at the bottle carefully. So much activities inside. I can only remember the word volcanic eruption. Didn't want it to lose that fizziness and carbonation, so had to taste it now, even though I thought to open after 2 days when we are celebrating my husband's birthday. And this was the best kavas I have ever made. Today I'm scared to open it after yesterday's event, so ask my husband to open it. After all, it's his birthday gift. It's okay to be devil sometimes. all my hard work gone. Before going, it has painted the table, the camera lens, the wall, the glass, everything with a vibrant red color. I quickly brought back the other bottle. This is still very active since I closed the cork, though it came out few times, but I put it back quickly so the carbonation is still there. I promised him an excellent bit covers, but he only getting shock after shock. But thing like this happens in fermentation. And finally, he is happy and satisfied, and me too. If you like this video, comment below, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe with the bell button. Stay happy, stay healthy.